so we're playing AC Deucey. You get to pick your doubles, and
I don't know if I ever told you, I have a friend who said he never played backgammon. Okay. He never played backgammon because it's all luck, and it turns out the only thing he had learned was like AC Deucey against somebody. Who always hit the, they pick your doubles, and when I explained to him that that's not actually real, he'll show up one of these times. He'll definitely.
Okay.
What do I want to do there? Now, would you have taken that?
Probably, because you are ahead in the race.
I just felt like I needed you to roll a 6-1, so you had a bad 6, or else you're just going to close me out.
Well, maybe you're right.
Yeah.
I mean, you are ahead in the race, though, and that's frequently.
It is a race after all.
Well, I mean, you have to get out, so it might not become a race. So, who knows?
Well, it's the old, it's always correct to double, because then your opponent gets to make the mistake, right?
Yes.
Oh, wait.
Million returns.
Really? That's how you're going to play me? My clock's been on this side the whole time.
Let's see.
I'm sure of is that.
Oh yeah, right. That's
18 is nice. I'm gonna try this.
I think that's right, because the moment you did that, I saw the duplication of twos and fours, and I have to strip to hit you. So that just seemed like that's more flexible.
Yeah.
Hit there. And then where are my awesome sixes that work tremendously well for me? Oh, there aren't any. Pass some of your spares. Not working at all. Oh, there.
Yeah, no. Although all these other things are showing up. Tune up.
Frankly, the whole thing's scary. It's AI. Auto double? No.
Not this time.
So then that's going. This guy keeps making his 5-point. I figured out that that's maybe one of the tricks.
Figured it out, huh?
Yeah.
You gotta get it before he does. Good idea.
The light bulb moment.
That's right.
I'm so used to the clock over there. Yeah, your midpoint's awfully stacked.
What? Shots.
Thank you.
I think they're smaller in diameter, so the ratio is a little different. They're probably the same thickness as others.
Okay.
Yeah, no way.
I would have two, three.
Yeah, no, I had to roll a double five or a double six to be, you know, back in the race on that, and I can't bank on the 1 in 18 shot or whatever. Yeah, it's just not gonna happen.
All right, 4-0.
Thank you for taking the time to take a look at all.
I mean, I saw the possibility of me winning it, but then I saw, like, a lot more possibilities.
Just in a normal sequence, I take off two, you come out, and now I'm on roll,
and then
no misses.
Yeah, we both have three off, and what if I get little numbers, and now
Plus, I can roll a double, take four off. So I was pretty sure it was a pass, Whoops.
Oh, something. I don't like this thing. I like a dedicated clock.
Okay, now it's. I think it's going now.
Yeah, I thought I had that one at some point.
I thought you did too, man.
And you know why they call it backgammon?
I looked into it. Crash and ace point games like that win about 6%. So it's not hopeless, but it's bad.
But when the argument is it's not hopeless, it's not a strong argument.
Right.
It's better than shooting yourself in the head.
Yeah. But I'm saying that it's better than like having, one man closed out.
A
little bit better.
Well, good luck to everybody.
I'll see your double five.
Yes.
Where is Charlie when you need him?
Charlie is in Arizona, but he's playing it for us. He's rolling the dice for us.
Yeah, right. he and I played on... Sunday morning, I guess.
All right, guys, good luck. Good to see you.
All righty. Good to see you. All right.
The diagram and the how to mentally shift points lesson.
Oh, if I won this way, then that mirrors.
I never use that. A lot of people do.
I've tried to learn that. What is it? The color, the coconut.
You seen the colorless count?
Yeah, colorless counting. Count up on the diagonals, and then it's so much mental gymnastics. I never quite get to where it's useful.
Yeah, it's really out of order.
Should re-roll, I was interfering.
Two.
looks like it goes all the way in.
Yep.
All right.
So. Let's see.
Can you mentally shift checkers to seats to head and race? You know how you don't want a gap in your four?
Three.
I put just the right kinetic energy on that shake.
Yes, you did. I didn't. Pass.
Okay. So, hey, I'm on the board.
So let's see. We hit this somewhere. How do we stop? Oh, like that. He's got the magic touch.
Yeah.
Dana and I can't do it to save our lives. Or what?
So how much of a liability was your gap on the 4-point versus the pip count there?
Well, cost me about another pip or so. Maybe two, maybe more. Plus you had one extra man off. Plus I had spares on the two.
So with eyesight, you put that put you at 59?
I came up with 60 to, or 53 to 60.
53 to 60, right.
Which...
And add six for right.
No.
No.
What should you be about that?
That one moved itself. I enticed him into recirculating my checker.
She's got, now that she plays out in the tournament, she's got to jump in on the table.
Yeah.
She's worried about her language.
Yeah, well, I would never fuck a curse over back at the table. I'll tell you that. Oops, was this recorded? It really does kind of teach you that some stuff's beyond your control.
Yeah.
Control, though, right?
No, that's like, true. It's like life.
Yeah, it's not. It's a better, I think, an analog for life than chess.
Absolutely.
It's great. Yeah, because some people definitely are luckier in situations for whatever reason. Well, yeah. I don't know what else you do with a 6-5. The way the game is played these days. Now, in the old days,
it's 17.
You leave multiple blocks to. Well, I guess I'm leaving you behind. Oh, brutal. I rolled a double six. It was a game changer, and he responded with the same. I'm going to need another one now. And
yes.
Then the dice are going to get tired.
The dice are going to get
tired. Yeah, then we're just going to roll one threes. See? Did I call it?
Those things.
Yeah. Yeah, I might want a one later. good news is once it gets to Crawford, I have zero doubling errors.
Yep. XG will agree.
And once in a while, you'll pull this game out and win.
See, I needed another one of those to get back on the bus. Check out this cube. He's quitting. He's quitting. I was gonna cube him.
Fourth. Check out this cube.
That was a lot of double sixes toward the end. That was volatile as hell. That's your ad for F&G, right?
Yeah, right.
Plus, I want a six to go. You know.
Did you get it? Yeah, there you go. You got it.
Right.
Oh. Oh. Two more.
That was very robust of you, Gammon.
Yes.
Very robust. Yes.
The robustness is off the charts.
Working on both of it.
Why, thank
you. Your sandwich is over there.
Okay. Can I do something good?
Maybe. Just maybe.
Thank you. I'm glad I rolled my larger numbers first during the barrel. This is where I play the game of, I think I know what he's going to do.
Well, let's see. Go 4 or 5. This doesn't work. This doesn't work. So 3s, 4s, 5s, and 6s.
For some reason, I have it stuck in my mind that 5 and 2 is better than 6 and 1, and in situations like that, just as a like a memorized position.
Oop. All right.
Wow. Wow. That's a nice like, boom, the coup de grace.
Yep.
All right.
Well done, gentlemen.
Well, I'm allowed to go home because Pam always tells me don't come home if you don't win.
There you go.
Here, hold on. So I'm gonna put your match on line.
Since it's the fight.
Yeah.
And then you're gonna hear.